Dear friends, please sit down and take a glimpse of this play. This play is going to make you acquaint with symptoms, causes, and remedies of malaria. Hope it is going to be informative for you. Father enter in the house. He is very tired and sits on a chair. Children are in their room studying.
It is so hot. Dia, send me a glass of cold water.
Wait a minute. John, give your sir a glass of cold water and ask him if he would like to have juice.
Okay, ma'am. Here is a glass of water, sir. Would you like to have juice?
No, thanks. Where is your madam?
In the chicken.
In the chicken? You nincompoop. Get lost.
Oh, sorry, sir. I mean to say in the kitchen.
Okay, okay. Where are my children?
They are dancing for tomorrow's exam.
Dancing for tomorrow's exam? You marvel. Are they dancing or studying?
Oh, sorry, sir. They are studying in their room for tomorrow's exam.
Now listen. Inform the children to be on the dining table after 10 minutes. I am going for a shower.
You are going for a shower?
Not shower. I am going for a shower. You fruitcake. Get lost.
Okay, sir. Okay.
After 10 minutes, everyone assembled at the dining table, John serves food to everyone.
Mama will help you out. I am feeling sleepy.
Good night. Papa never spends time with us. He is always busy in his work.
It is not like that. He is working only for us. He wants to give us good life. Now let me tell you about malaria and dengue. See, both are more or less same infections transmitted by different mosquitoes. Both are not contagious. However, malaria multiplies in the liver and then in the red blood cells of an infected person, while dengue enters and reproduces in the white blood cells. The symptoms in both are more or less same, such as high fever, weakness, pain in joints, vomiting, diarrhea, blah blah blah.
But what about the treatment, Mom?
Once someone is diagnosed with malaria, the treatment of the same should be done as soon as possible before the red blood cells are affected. While in dengue, hospitalization is necessary only when adequate fluids cannot be consumed, the platelets drops, or the person becomes too weak.
Wow, Mom, you are quite witty. One thing more, what about remedies? John, please open the door.
Sorry to disturb you. We have all planned at this time to invite you for a party here and you can move on with your family.
Sure, please have a seat.
No, we are getting late. We have to invite other residents also.
By the way, why are your children away? Aren't they appearing for exams tomorrow?
I was teaching them about malaria and dengue. I got stuck with remedies.
Remedies? I can help them about remedies.
Even I know about remedies.
That's great. I will be glad if you share this information.
First of all, one should drink ample amount of water, intake healthy fresh vegetables and fresh things.
Yes, it's true. Secondly, say no to the canned and the frozen food. One should do regular exercise to keep body fit as a fiddle.
Thirdly, have a balanced diet. Fats are good if taken in required way.
Apart from all, one should keep its immune system strong to fight with any infection. The most important thing to prevent the infection from spreading is cleanliness.
Yes. Yes, it is true. Our surroundings should be kept clean and dry. During monsoons, the chances of getting infections are quite high. One should use mosquito repellent to avoid mosquito bites.
Thank you, both of you. It is really wonderful to know about this infection.
Okay, good night and all the best for your
Come on, it's too late. Let us go to bed.